This is Safe Conduct, a video installation created by British artist Ed Atkins in 2016. It features a dystopian airport security line where not just whole bodies, but each organ and appendage are subjected to examination, confronting us with a disturbing depiction of how human identity is being rendered in the 21st century digital realm. The protagonist of Safe Conduct is a 3D computer-generated character. This model falls into the uncanny valley, an example of a representation of humanity that tries too hard to be real, falling short of both authenticity and more abstract, friendly animations. The model might be detailed, but the texture of its skin and hair is too smooth and low quality, one of the giveaways that he is an imposter. The artificiality of the model is made especially clear in the dismemberment at the center of the work. We see him effortlessly remove his hands and nose, revealing not bones or veins or any sort of substance, but a smooth, generic red. Viscera are thrown into the gray airport security trays, but the scale is all wrong. A kidney is the same size as a brain, a skull is only a little bit larger than a dislodged tooth. At the time, the scenes are satirical. The parade of body parts is interjected with something ordinary, like a laptop, or absurd, like a tenderly handled pineapple. All this fakeness and strangeness doesn't make the installation lighthearted, however. It might not engender the solemn horror of images of actual people actually injured by actual violence, but it does create a deep sense of discomfort and violation. This creepiness could be seen as a mere spectacle, subjecting an uncanny animated body to a strange form of torture out of amusement or curiosity, reminiscent of pixelated video game violence. But viewers who can see beyond the dramatically absurd and ironic aspects of the work will recognize that this fake person is a little bit too real. The model's body might not be detailed enough, but it is still incredibly detailed. Its movements are even more convincing. His hands shake, he contorts his face like someone taking a selfie, and there's little of the improbable glitchiness associated with most CGI figures. These motions are actually human, performed by Atkins and then mapped onto the model, making it a surrogate for its creator. Surrogate is actually Atkins' preferred word for his protagonist, indicating how it substitutes for the artist himself and, in a broader sense, the rest of us viewers. The most compelling part of the surrogate, however, are his eyes. They're clear, somewhat watery, and incredibly expressive. In this clip, the eyes on the surrogate's decapitated head remain locked onto those of his whole body double, seeming to emote betrayal. At other times, his gaze shifts to the viewer in the real world. The surrogate stare doesn't quite succeed in creating empathy, but it blurs the lines between his artificiality and our reality more than we'd like. He gazes at us accusingly, recognizing yet another pair of eyes scrutinizing his dismembered body, but also examining us in turn. Sometimes he even seems to treat the other side of the screen as a mirror, checking himself out while pulling us deeper into the deconstruction of his identity. The real horror of Atkins' security line, however, is its standardized nature. As in real airport security, the same protocol applies everywhere. Everything is forced into identical, familiar gray trays, including, eventually, the entire body of the surrogate. In contrast to unique, graphic, and in some ways intimate pre-modern violence, these violations are predictably clean-cut, all conforming to the same, actually literal, code. This standardization allows for infinite repetition, the key breakthrough at the heart of modern industrial assembly lines and computer programming. It enables the creation of Atkins' work itself. Rather than making anything by hand, the artist buys his models on a website called TurboSquid and outsources more complicated design work. Each part of his work must be compatible with the established modeling protocols in order for it to smoothly flow from designer to market to Atkins and then out into museums. But this empowering standardization requires invasively examining all parts and throwing out or distorting those that don't fit right. This logic doesn't seem so bad when what's being tossed out are defective products or buggy code, but when it's applied to human identities, as in Atkins' piece, it is dangerous. Not only is the process itself inherently violent, as Safe Conduct shows, but it also creates the potential for the complexity and deviance in human nature to be thrown out. The surrogate, like most of the more detailed TurboSquid models, is white, male, and normatively attractive, suggesting how much human variation may be discarded when it has to be reconstructed in pixels. The high technology behind Atkins' work and its cultural context extends these implications to the more insidious examinations that have become a defining characteristic of modern life. Atkins may have been amplifying the growing sense of violation that would eventually result in the European Union's General Data Protection Regulations, the outrage over Cambridge Analytica's micro-targeting and its involvement in the US presidential election, and the increasing suspicion towards Facebook and other all-encompassing tech companies. It's easy to see the surrogate as standing in for all of ourselves in the digital realm, mindlessly passing our data, memories, and ultimately identities through machines. The ultimate purpose of these submissions might be reaping reward, like the plane, the battered surrogate boards at the end of the video, or free access to a social media platform, but that doesn't change the violent threat of the process itself. When viewing Atkins' work, we must become increasingly conscious of the fact that our identities are being broken down and screened, rendered into pixels or data cells, but still part of us and still violated.